Hello folks again, and another little episode from the shed. This here is the ballast tray and the gear that goes inside the topaz, the Thorn Topaz lantern, which was featured in the last video. And if you remember, I mentioned on there we had a dodgy lamp holder. So what we're going to do in this video, we're going to change this one for this one. If you remember before, in this one the lamp would flop around and wouldn't stay in. This was a really easy tray to get out of that lantern. Basically, 1, 2 and 3, unscrew, push it back up, and out it come, dead easy. And it came with a plug for the photocell. Now with photocells, I always, if I can, when I refurbish and rewire lanterns, I like to put one of these plugs on, because it is so easy for when you have to service the thing. You can just pull the unit out, and like I'm doing now. There's the 42 watt ballast there. Let's get it up to the camera. You can see that there. Is that upside down? It's upside down. Okay, let's try it that way. Aha, that's better, isn't it? There we go. I'm going, obviously, these electronic ballasts are dead easy to wire because they don't have no other gear. So let's see if we can get this one undone and see what we can see at the back of it. So in the bottom there is some very, very small Phillips in there, and on the back it's got a little nut on the back, so we'll have to see if we can hold that and then put that in there and then undo that. And this is a really fiddly job because they are really, really small. Right, put that there. And these are the one things that you don't really want to lose, because these small nuts and bolts are very difficult to get hold of. So is that the other one off there? Nearly there. I think we can, yeah, that's, I've just heard it fall off. There we go. So we'll put those over there because that's really small. And these are the two screws that we've got to keep. So we've got to put the new one on with that. Now we've got to look at the back of this and work out what goes where. So that is a lot different to that one. This will fit on there. The lines hold up, so we're just got to try and find out what is what and what goes where. So there we go, we can see on here which is which. So I would say one goes. And of course, these are not the easiest things to rewire. I think probably the easiest thing for me to do is to actually make the new holder up and put the new cables in there. So this isn't quite as simple, straightforward as one was thinking. But if you get a small screwdriver in here and see if we can get these. Sometimes you put a screwdriver in and you push and you can get them out. If not, I will have to cut and see what we can do with that. So two there and two there. Totally different wiring diagram. Oh well, there we go. Very different. So I don't think there's any chance of getting these off. So what one will have to do, we will have to cut and what I should do is I should put these two aside so I know what those two are. So that goes to one there, and cut this and then cut that one. So that's the old one, that is the old one off now. So here we go with a new one. So we just get that round there, make sure you got your wires all out the way. And see there. Now I think the good thing we're to do is to test to see what pins in there what by using the meter, because it's got 1 and 2 is one end of the lamp on here, and pin 3 and 4 is the other end of the lamp. Now I don't know about this, but I would know better if I had a switch start ballast, is which side the starter would go, and you could work it out from there. But as this is a electronic ballast, it could be that it doesn't matter which way they go around, but we'll just have to do trial and error. But the problem with these sockets are, these lamp holders, is once you press them in, that is it, they are in there. So you don't really get a second chance on these. So we'll just have to see how we go. If not, I'll have to do a complete rewire on these, but let's just strip these back and see what's what. And this cable isn't the best of stuff to strip, because it's rather, well, this is not too bad, but some of the sort of cables you get on there are really, really tight, and if you've got hot hands or your hands get sweaty, it's really impossible to strip these things back. Just trim them off a little bit, just make them a little bit more neater. There we go, a little bit more neater there. And so on and so forth. So, on the diagram, on here, it looks like that one set going one side and one set going the other. The thing is though, which ones do we put them in? Do we put them in the top one or the bottom one? Aha, yes. Well, by looking at this one, I'm going to say that, yes, I can see now, that would be this one and this one, because that one would be a cable out for if you were putting in another, linking this up to another lamp. So I'm going to go one side, that side, and that side, and that side. So this is what I'm going to do here, I can get it on the camera. So I'm going to push one in there like that. There you go, one in there like that. And I'm going to put the other one in the bottom, in there like that. And then these two, I'm going to put one in there like that. There we go. And then I'm putting the other one in there, just like that, if it will go in. These don't always play games, play ball, these. There we go. So there we have it. We have that actually fixed in there. There we go. Okay, so that is basically how you change it. I won't have enough time on the video to show you it fired up, but I will do a video on the lantern next time we do that. And then this, come round here like that, and basically all we've got to do is flatten the wires down and make sure that goes on there like so. We can pull the cables through onto that one, which I think you can do it on this. It might have to be a little bit proud. I don't think there's enough cable to go around the other side to that one, but that looks pretty okay like that. So it may be a bit proud, but you can adjust it because it's got long enough screws there for that one. So then what we do is pop that one in there like so, and then that should go straight in. And this is going to be really, really fiddly now. So that one will go in there, and then of course we just put the nut and bolt on the back there, little washer like that. Now that can go in. Whoop. This is a bit where you'll find it extremely, extremely fiddly to do. It's sort of a three-hand job really doing this, but we've got that one on there. And then the very small nut, is that gonna go? It should do. And it's quite painful as well, sticking your finger in that holder. Look, it's a dent on your finger. But there we are, let's see if we can just get this. But this is basically the gist of it, you just change one of these over. But this is going to be really problematic actually. It's not as easy getting them on, especially when you've got like sausage fingers. I mean, I've got fairly thin fingers, but this is really going to be a pain in the backside. But there we are, never mind. Let's try and doing it this way round. Maybe we can get this bit of bolt on there by doing that. And by, yes, we got it. We have got it. So anyway, there's the gist. That'll sit on there like that. I can tighten that up as much as I want, or as little as I want. We can get the cables, tidy the cables up a bit. But basically, that is how we can change that lamp holder. So what I'll do another video, just to follow this little one up of this being on. And I can promise you that the lamp, when I get a lamp, we'll click in this. See, the other one, the old one, see, look, wouldn't clip on. But this one, I can promise you, is there, brilliant. So that'll sit like that, go back in the lantern, and then we'll fire it up, and I'll show you later on another video. So stay tuned for that. If you are following along, you do so at your own risk, and we'll hope that this works quite well. But thanks for this little short video. Could have been a little bit longer, but I've only got a limit of 9 minutes on my SD card. So I'm going to have to sign off now. I'll do another video of this. Subscribe if you haven't been subscribed. Give it a thumbs up. And tick the bell icon for notifications of future vids. So for me in the shed, take care. And we'll see you on the next one.